Hey, so I found a use for my FD imprinter now. I'm making stencils for airbrushing my 3D printed fishing lures. And I just wanted to share the basic process with you. So I use this Voroni plugin on Fusion 360 to generate these Voroni patterns. I think that's how you pronounce that. Also a few places online that I'll link to where you can create these patterns as well. If you have like a Cricut or any kind of cutter or a laser cutter, you can generate these and export them to SVG and slice them on those things as well. Go into Fusion with this plugin, you'll see this like little new icon after you install it. I just click on that. I change the dimensions to 140 by 140, which gives me a good kind of area to work with. It loads, and then you click on, you know, edit Voroni, brings up this cool little interface, and you can just start messing around with the settings. There's one setting that is absolutely important to this process. You scroll down and you click this add border option. That's crucial. That's crucial when we go to extrude this Voroni pattern to make our stencil, that we have this border. Otherwise, you can't select the right areas. So again, you just kind of slide these around. This is some settings that I found work pretty well. It's not a exact process. You just have to kind of fiddle around and figure out which ones you like. There's also options up here that you can create different types of patterns with different shapes. I've almost exclusively used the curve so far, and that seems to work pretty well. So once you get something you're happy with, you just click this send to Fusion. And then you have this pattern in here. Now, Fusion is gonna be kind of mad at you at this point. It doesn't like working with objects or sketches with lots of curves. So you're gonna end up with waiting around a little bit while this process completes. So once you get the pattern in there, all we need to do is extrude it. So you hit the E button or click the extrude command. Click next to the border, you wanna select the negative space basically around these little globs, if you will. And I was extruding mine 0.5 millimeters. You can play around with this as much as you want, but you want it relatively thin so it stays flexible. Then once you extrude it, you're done. Export it to STL and print it. So I've printed them both on PLA, and I had some flexible TPU filament around that I had never used before. The PLA is great. At half a millimeter, it's relatively flexible. But it doesn't really, you can't get it really right up against the lure, at least the lures that I had. But if you just want to kind of hold it relatively flat along a side and brush through it, PLA is just fine. Now the TPU was really, really cool. It maintains extreme flexibility, it's stretchy. You can clip it onto your lures with some clips to get it right up against the edge, and you can really wrap it around the whole lure. I hope you found that useful. If you want these files, they're over in my Patreon group where I share everything. Link to that in the description below. Take care. Tight line.